I am Sauchanya and I am here to teach you all a topic from our economics. So before starting about economics, about the topic, let me first introduce you all about what is social studies. Okay, what is social studies? Social studies is nothing but a study or research about society. About society. So study or research about our society or our locality or our surroundings, whether it is our area, our colony, our constituency or our state or our country or nation or continent or world, all this comes under social studies. Study of society is called social studies. So this social studies is categorized into four parts. One is polity, second one is economy, third is geography, and the fourth one is history. So let us quickly get an idea of what polity, economy, geography and history is. So polity is nothing but our politics. How to govern, how to rule ourselves, to making our society in an organized way, we have set few rules and regulations. So all those set of rules and regulations will be coming into the topic polity. This is in short. Then what is economy? Economy is nothing but it means about money, revenue generation, how to use it, where money comes from, how we are spending that money, budget sessions, income, expenditures, demand, supply, market, all these things come into our economy, which is very much important in our day-to-day life. Right from the moment we get up till the moment we sleep, of course, even the time of sleeping, we need to use this electricity and all this. So all these things are related to economy. Coming to the third point of our social studies is geography. Geography is where we are, what is the kind of land we are standing here, what minerals do we have, what resources do we have, what are renewable resources, non-renewable resources, human resources, all these things come into the topic of geography. And last but not the least, history. History is knowing about our past, what happened just 5 minutes ago, 1 hour ago, last year, 10 years ago, 50 years ago, 100 years ago, all this past, whatever has happened, all that comes into history. So here you may get a question like, why should we learn history, ma'am? Yes, history is very much important for each and every individual. History tells us what is good, what is bad. See, our parents tell us like, don't do this, don't touch fire. It is out of their experience. They touched it, they hurt themselves, and it is out of their experience. They teach their kids that no, don't go near fire. Be careful. So all the experiences of our ancestors is written, and that is available in the form of history. If someone does good, what are the benefits he got? How he was appreciated by the people? How he or she was loved by the society? Or if someone did something wrong, how he was punished, and in what ways his people or her people had to face the problems, consequences of that, all that is inculcated in the topic of history. So these are the four areas of social studies. So in this topic for today, we are going to first deal with economics. I told you, right, economics is very, very important. So I'm going to start with the topic economics. The first topic in our economics is development. Most of the times, everybody uses in their life this word development. Max, every at least 4 to 5 times I will be using the word development. Of course, your parents also, children must be using the word development. Where is the progress in your marks? Where is the development in your communication? developmental ideas. The same way each and every individual will have their own developmental ideas. So as an individual, as a citizen, I may feel like there should be availability of 100% quality education to students who are born in our country. There should be good employment facilities provided to youth, educated youth. There should be no orphanage in this world. The country's GDP should increase, imports should get minimized, and exports should be more. That could be my developmental ideologies when I think about a country. So here, let me give you an example of a person who is landless rural laborer. Landless rural always available. have some kind of observation around you. Like in your student, your teachers, or your friends here, we have domestic workers here in our school, your parents,